Snap Captions just released a huge update that allows us to make effects like Iman Gadzhi. This new tool called Snap Ultimate has tons of cool things like a depth effect, drop shadow, word by word animation, and a lot more. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use this tool to create some really cool captions for your project. If you're not familiar with Snap Captions, it's a tool that allows you to take the subtitle system in DaVinci Resolve and instantly turn it into a text plus animation. Me and Orson have worked together to create this really cool preset that I think all of you are going to love. Let's install Snap Ultimate real fast. Import the bin to your master bin. You're going to see either the pro version or the free version. We're going to be using the pro version just to show you guys what all it has, but if you want to get the free version, that's just fine. Put the text effect on your timeline and set it up to how you want it to look for all of your captions. This is going to be using the styles category of Snap Ultimate, and now let's get to the fusion page. Let's go ahead and click on merge 4 and just type in mosaic. This is going to give us the mosaic blur effect, and this is how we're going to create our really cool animation. I'm not going to use keyframes. I'm actually going to demonstrate my tool and utility just to give you guys an example of how to use it. So if you come up here to workspace and open up the script, it's going to open it up right in the center and allow you to type in the name of whatever control you want to actually animate. We'll type in pixel for pixel frequency because that's what we want to animate right now. We'll select it, we'll keep the name whatever we want it to be and hit paste. We can also type in blend and we're going to find the one that has a capital B for control ID and for control name. Select that and press paste again. You can see there are two modifiers we just created are actually right here ready for us to use. We're going to start with the pixel frequency modifier and change the rest number to go to start and end number and change rest number to 500. It's a small bug right now with Resolve 19 that forces all hidden controls to be visible. When you use this in Resolve 18 and hopefully in future updates, it's not going to look like this. But we're just going to demonstrate for right now because this tool is still usable. It just doesn't look as pretty. So now we don't want it to last for 24 seconds, which in this timeline is less than a second because I'm on a 60 FPS timeline. I actually want this to be 10 frames and we're going to keep our start and end times at 0 frames. We need to come over here to blend and switch the rest number to 0 and the start and end number to 1 and then change this to 5 so it takes up half the time of the other animation and it's also going to start halfway through the other animation as well. This ensures that it actually gives the pixel effect and it will slowly gradually turn into the regular looking text. This is so that we don't have a whole lot of lag happening. All right, and with that we have full animations with no keyframing needing to be done, and if you click off and click back onto the node you can even customize your curves for in and out. With that done, now we can see we have our animation coming in and out. We can go ahead and drag this up to our Snap Captions folder and rename it to whatever we'd like. I'm going to rename it to Ultimate Mosaic, and we can either delete or hide this track. We already have our subtitles created. I did that way before the video. So we're just going to go ahead and activate Snap Captions now and select our Ultimate Mosaic and set up Snap Captions to however you want it to set it up. And instantly we have really fast, really simple to use blur in and blur out effect. But that was how you can do it all on your own. I'm also going to be giving away a pack that includes all of the effects except for Iman Gadzhi's effect down in the description on my Ko-fi page. Next up, for Iman Gadzhi, we're going to go ahead and use Snap Ultimate again, and we're going to actually do this the slow way and then the fast way at the end. First of all, with the slow way, all we have to do is go into Fusion here, find our face node, which is going to be our template node here, and we're just going to disable all of the effects we don't want, which is going to be Snap Emphasis, Snap Highlight, and if you want to keep any of the styles on, you can. We're going to go ahead and right click and insert Character Level Styling. This is going to allow us to select text in our viewer and change aspects of it over here on the inspector. But with the top text selected, we're going to choose a font that is a lot thinner. As you play through this, it does not have any animation yet. So what we have to do is come back over here to the edit page, go about halfway on our clip, and just give it a little cut. Back into Fusion on the second clip, and just swap the half of your text that has that smaller font. We'll have to set this other font back to how it was. This is a pretty slow way of doing it. You have to do that for every single caption that you want to have that same animation on it, and it's not automated in any way. So if we play through it, it's gonna look pretty good. But let's make that even better. Remove our effect that we just made and actually put in the pro version of Snap Ultimate. Disable anything that you don't want enabled, just like we did before. With only Snap Emphasis turned on, go into Fusion and find the section that says Snap Emphasis down here below word by word. You're going to click on the node that starts with instance right here and go over to the inspector. This is where you can change all the aspects of the highlighted text that you get when you use Snap Ultimate, which changes over time. De-instance the font group. This will allow us to change the font to something more like Gothic once again. To change the color of this text, if you just come back over here to the template node and come over here to emphasis, you can change all of this to pure white. So there we go. I'm not going to make a version of this. If you want to get this, buy Snap Ultimate and it will allow you to quickly and easily create the same effect. Drag that into your bin and then change it to say Iman style. If you have a problem like this, all you have to do is make sure that it is a two-line text and it will work just fine. And if you have something like this to where it's not going to work right, you can come on down here to emphasis and just turn that off. There you go. You just did Iman Gadzhi's captions. There is one more I want to show off, and this one is actually pretty sought after when it comes to captioning. The karaoke effect is a very popular effect that many people want to use, but in DaVinci, there's no straightforward way of actually getting it to look right. However, what we can do is kind of simulate the same thing. Come down here to styles and enable word by word captioning. This will allow us to have words coming in evenly throughout the entire length of our clip. Copy the template node and do a shift paste with a different area of the comp selected. We're gonna then merge the other instance that we just created over the template node, switch the mask input from template into instance template. And by default, we're not gonna see anything happening in our screen up here. We can come over here to shading now and start changing things for this other font. Going to add a box around our text. There may be a color option right here, but right now DaVinci 19 is being a little bit buggy with certain things. If you don't see that option, you can always come over here to gradient and change your colors to be however you want them to be. Come walk over here to template. We're actually gonna see blue border is enabled for that as well. But let's go ahead and real quick, disable that and change an instance. Right click the enable and press deinstance. That's gonna let us have one of them enabled and one of them disabled. And if we play through it, we're actually gonna see it comes in, but it stays in. Come over here to shading now, and we're gonna change this animation right here on opacity, which is at the moment just popping in one frame using anim curves. Remove anim curves from that, and we're just gonna animate this manually this time. So bring opacity down to zero, bring it in one frame, and bring opacity back up to one. We're gonna come out 10 frames and bring opacity back down to zero, and what we're gonna see is a nice quick fading effect. All we have to do now is come back over here to tools, come over here to the user tab, and change this to be 10. That's telling our animation engine that it needs at least that many frames before it brings in our other word. But we're still having it fading in and out. Come up here to your spline panel. Make sure that you have show only selected tool enabled. Select opacity 8 and make it full screen. Now we're going to select everything in this graph and just click this button right here. This is going to make it to where that first frame is going to be nothing. But then right after that, for the next 9 frames, it's going to actually show the word in full opacity. And just like that, we have instant karaoke captioning done with Snap Ultimate. Go ahead and bring this up to your bins once again and change this to be karaoke. Now, as I mentioned before, I am creating a pack that includes the two other effects besides Iman Gadzhi. This pack works the exact same way as importing the bin from Snap Captions. Once you install it, make sure that it's in the master bin and it will create a new bin called Snap Captions. You'll have one called Ultimate Karaoke and another one called Ultimate Mosaic. They should be just ready to go if you want to generate those captions. Beyond that, if you also want to customize anything, come over here to the animation tab and you're able to customize all the animations on the Mosaic one. As we just saw in Karaoke, we don't have the same animation engine being used as we do in Mosaic, which means we don't have the same customization ability that we do in this caption. And as you can already tell, these actually don't use Snap Ultimate at all. I want to clarify that I'm not going to be selling a version of Snap Ultimate because I want you to go out and buy it yourself. If you really want these effects in Snap Ultimate, you can always take the nodes and paste them into Snap Ultimate yourself. As long as you don't sell them, you're just fine. You can now make insane captions for your videos. And I'm sure you already have some ideas on how you can customize Snap Ultimate. Now, if it wasn't clear at the start, I did work with Orson to make this tool. If you're interested in getting Snap Ultimate or my own pack, those links are going to be down in the description, along with a link to Anim Utility, my Anim engine I showed off. Now, if you watch this video not knowing much about the Text Plus tool, I applaud you. You made it this far and you don't know what you're doing yet? Well, if you don't, go ahead and watch this video right here, where I go over a bunch of different text animations you can do.